Though I say it is complicated, it is the most common refractive error, right? It's present in most of the people. Let's understand what is happening in astigmatism. We know that in a normal eye, the cornea is spherical in shape and hence it focuses the rays on the retina with a single focal point. But look at this cornea over here. It is distorted in shape. You can compare it to the cornea over here. The cornea is kind of oval in shape, so it cannot focus the rays of light in a single focal point. At some place it is steep and another place it is flat. So the rays focus front, in front of the retina and behind the retina. So it will have two different points of foci. That is the pathogenesis in corneal astigmatism. Now see, let's say the periphery of the cornea is steep, that is it's bending the rays of light more, so they will focus in front of the retina, and because the center is flat, they will focus the rays of light behind the retina. So there will be two foci, but somewhere in between these two foci you will have a clear image. That point is given by the Sturm's conoid. So look at this image. This tells you about the Sturm's conoid. These two lines, the yellow color and the blue color, they represent the planes in the incident beams, vertical and horizontal. And these two, this is the vertical and this is the horizontal. These are the focal points, the two different foci that are present in astigmatism. And the point between these two where there is absolutely perfect vision is called the circle of least confusion. And when you're correcting astigmatism, you will try to focus the image at this point. Okay, this is the circle of least confusion, that is the center point between the two foci of vertical and horizontal rays. Okay, so the Sturm's conoid is the cone that is formed between the two focal points, and the circle of least confusion has the best visual acuity. Now let's look at the correction of astigmatism. We have seen that there is a circle of least confusion between the two focal points of the astigmatic cornea, and that you will correct with a toric lens or a cylindrical lens. And we have seen in spherical errors that we will give the prescription and denote with the letter S. Here, because you're giving a cylinder, you will use the letter C and you will mention the axis. Okay. The axis can be from 1 degree to 180 degrees of astigmatism. This is how a toric lens looks and it is used to correct an astigmatic eye. Now let's take an example and compare the three different refractive errors we have studied until now. If you ask the patient to look at the letter A on this Snellen's chart, the myope will say that he cannot see anything. The hypermetrope will be able to read anything, everything within the Snellen's chart very clearly. Why? Because we have seen there is increased accommodation. However, he will have eye ache and headache and asthenopia. Okay. Now, the problem with astigmatism is that he can see only half of the letter correctly and the remaining half will be blurred. That will be his problem. So he will have the maximum eye strain and maximum asthenopia. Okay. The minor amount of astigmatism would create more problem than that caused by large amounts of hypermetropia, because half of it is clear and half of it is hazy. So he will have more annoying visual clarity, resulting in more asthenopia. Okay. So, in your question, if you get this question, your answer will be asthenopia is maximum in astigmatism. See, we already know that there are two foci in astigmatism and the cornea is shaped like a rugby ball. Okay. So, this tends to distort the light more along one direction than the other. Now, look at this. You will have to see something like this, but in astigmatism, in the horizontal focus it appears like this and vertical focus is something like this. Okay, so the lines running in one direction may appear to be clearer, while lines running in the opposite direction might be more blur. That is, suppose let's say the vertical axis may be more clear and horizontal axis might appear blurred. So this is the reason for maximum asthenopia and highly distorted vision in astigmatism. But there are a few types of astigmatism that you will have to memorize. It's pretty easy. Now, if you look at these images, you can easily memorize what happens. The first type is simple myopic. Now, myopia, we know that the rays focus in front of the retina. So, in simple myopia, one of the focal point is in front of the retina and the second focal point is on the retina. Right? One of them is in front and the second focal point in astigmatism is on the retina. Similarly, in simple hypermetropic astigmatism, one of the rays will focus on the retina and the other one, just as in hypermetropia, will focus behind the retina. Because one is focusing on the retina, you will term it as simple. Coming to compound, you can understand that both of the focal points will lie in front of the retina. Similarly, in compound hypermetropic, both the foci will lie behind the retina. Okay? Simple, one focuses on the retina. Compound, both are focusing either in front or behind the retina. When I say mixed astigmatism, you can understand it will be a mixture of myopia and hypermetropia. That means one focal point is in front of the retina and the other focal point is behind the retina. That is mixed astigmatism. Now, based on the source of contribution of the cause for the myopia, it can be either corneal. Corneal is further divided into regular, oblique and irregular astigmatism. We'll understand what is regular and oblique. First, let us look at irregular astigmatism. It is caused by irregular surface of cornea seen in corneal scars and keratoconus, and it is highly difficult to treat. This corneal astigmatism, most common cause of astigmatism. It can also be caused by some lenticular cause or a retinal cause. Based on the axis of astigmatism, it can be either regular or oblique. We have just seen that corneal astigmatism is divided into regular and oblique based on the axis. Now, regular astigmatism is again divided into with the rule and against the rule. Now, let's try to understand so that you can remember in your exam. So, what is oblique astigmatism? Any astigmatic axis lying between 30 to 60 degrees between this or 120 to 150 degrees is oblique astigmatism. Please memorize this so that you won't get confused in your exam. 30 to 60, 120 to 150. Anything lying in between these is oblique astigmatism. And outside of this will be regular astigmatism. Oblique 30 to 60, 120 to 150. Other than that, everything is regular astigmatism. Now, we know regular astigmatism is again divided into with the rule and against the rule. So, with the rule is more commonly seen in young patients and they have a better visual acuity. This, the corneal shape is important because the vertical curvature of the cornea is greater than the horizontal curvature. If you look at this, see the vertical axis is more bent as compared to the horizontal axis. This is with the rule astigmatism. And what you have to memorize here is when you give a plus cylinder at 90 or a minus cylinder of 180, that you will answer as with the rule astigmatism. Plus 90 or minus 180 is with the rule. Okay, just memorize this. Plus 90, minus 180 with the rule. Now, against the rule is seen in elderly people and it depends on the corneal shape again. The horizontal curvature will be greater than vertical curvature, just opposite to with the rule astigmatism. And opposite to this as well, the correction will be minus 90 or plus 180 is against the rule. Plus 90, minus 180 with the rule. Minus 90, plus 180 is against the rule. If you memorize this, you can answer all the questions.
Hello everyone. This is Dr. Sai Suguna, your mentor for ophthalmology at MedicoApp. Thanks for watching the video. Now we have put such videos all together in our ophthalmology app. The trial version you can download from the link over here or in the description box below.